He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We just learned about oxidative addition, so now let's learn about what is essentially the reverse process, reductive elimination. To see what this reaction accomplishes, we can truly just take the generalized equation for oxidative addition and reverse it, so that the complex with ligands A and B and the metal in the N plus 2 oxidation state is now the reactant, and this will reduce to the metal in the N oxidation state while also yielding AB. Just like with oxidative addition, complexes with stable MN and MN plus 2 oxidation states will be good candidates, and in particular those that seek to eliminate a formal positive charge, or those that have electron withdrawing substituents. Let's take for example this iridium complex with a polyhapto ligand, a trimethylphosphine, a hydride, and a methanide. If this were to undergo reductive elimination, what would result? Well, we just learned that oxidative addition allows molecular hydrogen and alkanes to split apart and coordinate to the metal, and reductive elimination is the reverse process, so it makes the most sense for hydride and methanide to combine to form methane. Once again, iridium will have its oxidation state reduced by 2 as a result of this process. Complexes that undergo reductive elimination are primed for oxidative addition, as they now have lower oxidation states and coordination sites available, so a molecule like benzene could then react to produce this complex, as it is the case that even aromatic CH bonds can undergo oxidative addition. Indeed, oxidative additions and reductive eliminations are basic steps in some important catalytic reactions we will see later in the series. Reductive elimination is quite straightforward mechanistically, and it is extremely common, often taking place in order to allow for another reaction to occur. Take for example this tungsten complex with 2 CP ligands, a methanide and a hydride. Let's say this is to react with benzene in some manner. What is the count on this complex? Well, each of the 4 ligands has a 1 minus charge, and the complex is neutral, so tungsten is 4 plus, meaning it has only 2 valence electrons. Plus 12 from the cyclic ligands, and another 4 from the other 2. That brings us to 18. This means the complex is coordinatively saturated, and also quite crowded sterically. Benzene will not be able to coordinate. But this complex is capable of reductive elimination. The methanide and hydride ligands can leave as methane, and then there will be open sites for benzene to undergo oxidative addition, leaving the phenyl ligand and a new hydride ligand. So again, we will often see reductive elimination in conjunction with other reactions. As we would expect, just in the way that oxidative addition leaves 2 new ligands cis to one another, the ligands that leave via reductive elimination must usually be cis to one another in order for the new bond to form. Here is an iridium complex with 2 triphenylphosphines, 2 hydrides, a chlorine, and a carbonyl. The metal is 3+, and the electron count is 18. These 2 hydrides are cis to one another and can therefore eliminate to form H2. So the resulting complex will have a 1+ charge and an electron count of 16. The relevant intermediate is difficult to observe, but it is thought that the H2 molecule will remain coordinated to the metal in this manner for some time prior to dissociating. So we can see that similar to stepwise oxidative addition, stepwise reductive elimination is also possible. We must remember that since oxidative addition and reductive elimination are reverse processes, the products of one can serve as the reactants of the other, and these reactions can both be reversible. Usually one side will be thermodynamically favored, which can be utilized in synthesis. And as we mentioned, sometimes reductive elimination followed by oxidative addition is a good way to substitute one set of ligands for another, if the reactions required for such a transformation are favorable. However, we will see later that in some catalytic cycles, steps can occur that are not thermodynamically favorable as long as the change in Gibbs free energy is negative overall. But for now, let's move forward and check out some more organometallic reactions.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.